Hi guys, welcome to my channel Auto Tech with AJ. Confused which one to buy between the Mahindra XUV300 or the Tata Harrier? Well, both these vehicles are special in their own terms. The Mahindra XUV300 is doing very well in terms of sales. So, how does these two compare to each other in terms of their design, specs and price? Let's find out. But before we begin, please consider subscribing to my channel. The design for both these vehicles is fresh. The all-new Tata Harrier is based on the Land Rover D8 platform that has been heavily modified to form the Tata's Omega Arc platform. The Harrier is the first ever vehicle based on the new platform. It has quite unique features like the xenon HID projector headlamps below the dual function LED DRLs with turn indicators. The vehicle gets an aggressive stance with flared wheel arches, protective side claddings and 5 spoke alloy wheels wrapped in 235x65 R17 wide tires. At the back, there's a flowing LED tail lamp. The interior has premium oak wood finish dashboard, premium oak brown perforated leather seats and door pads inserts. The vehicle gets a soft touch dashboard with leather wrapped steerings and gear shift knobs. The all new XUV300 is based on the SsangYong Tivoli platform. On the front, the XUV300 has a slim grille with LED projector headlamps and daytime running lights, giving it a sophisticated look. The fog lamps are connected to the headlamps with a thin DRL strip. The characteristic lines above the wheel arches add muscle to the XUV300 along with the plastic cladding on the lower edge of the car. The XUV300 rides on 17-inch tires. The rear is characterized by a smart-looking tail lamp and an integrated spoiler. The chunky, thick C-pillar add to the solidity of the XUV300. The cabin looks airy with white leatherite material upholstery and black dashboard. Coming to the dimensions, well, there is just no comparison here. The Tata Harrier is bigger in all aspects. It is longer than the XUV300 by 603 mm, wider by 73 mm, higher by 89 mm and has a wheelbase advantage of 141 mm. It has 25 mm of more ground clearance and a bigger boot space by 168 liters. Well, these are basically two different segment vehicles. Moving to the power, the Tata Harrier has a bigger engine than the XUV300. Its cryotech 2-liter turbocharged engine is capable of producing a max power of 138 bhp and a max torque of 350 Nm, whereas the smaller 1.5 liter engine on the XUV300 is capable of producing a max power of 115 bhp and a max torque of 300 Nm. Both are mated to a 6-speed manual transmission for now. Looking at the features, the Tata Harrier has an advanced electronic stability program with 14 features like the anti-lock brake system, electronic brake force distribution, corner stability control, electronic traction control, electronic stability control, hill hold control, rollover mitigation, and a few others. It has 6 airbags on its stock version, fog lamps with cornering functions, 8.8 inch floating touchscreen infotainment system, 320 watt JBL audio with 9 speakers, voice recognition with digital color instruments cluster. The XUV300 offers a 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system with navigation, tire pressure monitoring system, and a segment-first dual-zone climate control with memory function. It has a multicolored instrument cluster which can be programmed to have different colors for night and day. The top end comes with 7 airbags and sunroof. Coming to the cost. Well, the Harrier is available from Rs 12.69 lakhs to Rs 16.25 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi. whereas the XUV300 diesel version is available from Rs 8.49 lakhs to Rs 12.14 lakhs, which means that the top end of XUV300 is cheaper than the starting Harrier by almost 55,000. Well, to conclude, if you want a big, sexy looking SUV and money is not your concern, then Harrier is for you. And if you want an economically value for money but with a bit small space and a good engine, then you can go for the XUV300. Guys, I hope you like this video. If you do, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe for all the latest reviews and comparisons in the automotive world.